Proxy means attending the class lectures, and meti means media integration tool for you. Now, it has got the functionality of presentation, synchronization, and with the images. You can publish the lecture and share it on the internet or intranet. The functionality which the previous software does is lecture presentation, you can import images, then you synchronize it, edit the lecture, and then publish and then view it. This is a preview of that software that we used to edit. Now the functionality that we are assigned to add is the conversion of PowerPoint presentation to the images directly, video streaming and downloading via FTP server that we have added so far, and VLC player integration and webcam capture, video cutting and database integration. That conversion of PPT to images, video streaming and downloading that me and Aditya has done, and this is Rishna. VLC part that Rajesh and Haseeb has done, and the last part database is Lavanya and Rishna has done. This is a use case diagram. There are two actors in it, that is an editor or a viewer, that is student. Editor has responsibility of import multimedia, edit it, webcam capture, slicing and publish it. And the viewer can search the lecture and view the lecture. Next, there's a DFD, two actors again, entities, editor and a student, the whole proximity. Editor has a job of, can give the videos, PPT and theme to the editing tool, and the publish lecture to the database and the publishing as a published lecture. Student can search by a video name and view the published application. This is a second level DFD. It had a four sorts of responsibilities, and the whole editing tool has been comprised of five jobs. You can see here, this conversion, binding, recording, splicing, and adding theme. And this is a DFD for a user. You can enter a search query, and the published list is seen to it. Select the lecture and can view the lecture. This is how the conversion of PPT to the images takes place directly. You can select the PowerPoint presentation, and the program will take it with the help of POI libraries, that is Poor Obfuscation Implementation Library. It's a project by Apache, and then whole each slide of the presentation is converted into the images. This is something about a little bit of POI project that Apache has launched it and is working, and this has got the very funny name, that is Poor Obfuscation Implementation. And the set of library has horrible spreadsheet format and horrible word format. It's also got a funny name in that. And it's working, and there's a lot of blogs and documentation available in this. And you can search more information on poi.apache.org. This is all about POI. Now, this is the second module, is video streaming and downloading. And so we have created an FTP server in that. And the request is seen by the client to view the lecture, and we can do the two jobs, either streaming or downloading the lecture in the client machine only and then view it. So two jobs can be simultaneously possible. So client search it and then download from the FTP server. This is a VLC power peer integration that's done by the IT teams and Haseeb and Rajesh. And this also a previous one. That is, you can give the slide name and starting and the ending time manually, and this slide gets binded to the lecture. This is the webcam capture feature, which is added by again our PLC team. This is a video slicing. You can start the video, you can stop the video, the whole slice of the video can be sliced, cut into the slice of the video, and you can save into the your time machine in any format. The project which we are using in the VLC part is VLCJ, which is hosted by Captia Software, which is a company in UK. So it is gives up the Java binding for the VLC player, and it's having the facility to join the native VLC player to the string application. Besides this, it also got the various functionality, that's volume control, that you can snap the player. You can have the full screen support, multiplayer instance can also be supported in that. So it's very good project, a lot of blog and documentation also available for that. And you can find more information on captiasoftware.co.uk, and lot of code is available on the Google code and Wiki also. From here I would like to Sudeshna to be continue.
Good morning, one and all. This is the database integration part. Basically, we started with the basic tables in the Postgres. That is the video table is the main video table, and the slide table it contains the VID, which is actually the primary key of the, and then the slide ID and the slide name. After that, this is a slide video. That is, instead of the slides, you can have the videos also. That it can be integrated with the main video. Actually, this was the basic part we did, and after that, we actually started doing it with MO model, but we had only 1.5 weeks left, so we just studied and we couldn't implement that. These are the extensions which we were still doing it. We were rebuilding the front end in JavaFX 2.0, which had been released on 26 May 2011. By then, we had completed half of our internship. So after that, it was like we came to know about JavaFX 2.0 and all its syntax, and everything was different. It was like this Java Swing channel. Then after that, we were doing the publishing the edited multimedia lecture in the VLC media player. Previously, we were using the JavaFX media player. Now we started with the VLC media player, which could use all the formats like the MPG and SLV and all. Next, integration of the backend utilities. In this, we had done that slide to image conversion, and which were done basically in Java, which could be actually easily now integrated with the JavaFX 2.0. Previously, calling an object from JavaFX to Java and Java to JavaFX were all very difficult. Now it became little user friendly, and we added some. These are to be done. Enhanced searching capabilities through ML. We have done the only, we could get only the UUID part, that is a basic ID, and remaining part still needs to be done, by which the searching capabilities could be more improved. In the MO, basically, if you enter any property of that attribute, we could search all the details about that. Suppose some XYZ is the creator of this video. So if you enter XYZ, you can get all the details regarding him. What are the videos about him, and what are the slides which are present, and details about him, etc. These are the technologies we use. Java for the back end, and JavaFX 2.0 for the front end, and the Apache POI library, OpenOffice library, VLC player and the VLCJ library, Postgres SQL, and the MO. For the future, implementation of the MO model in the database to enhance the searching capabilities, and the online streaming of the video lectures. At present, we tried it with the FTP server, by which we could download the videos which were present in the server into the client, and the client could view the lectures which were present in the server, and accordingly the slides and all. And we could create a blog and a web page for the proximity.